I get told to toughen up and sort of shake it off a fair bit. I got asked if I was addicted to drugs because I'd lost so much weight. So I think there's that sort of ignorance around sort of mental health as a whole with people, but sort of there's the ignorance of sort of body image issues with males a lot. It's kind of weird because you sort of bond over a bad situation, but even though everyone's struggling, they sort of want everyone to sort of get better and sort of we work together to sort of help each other. Even if like the treatment wasn't working per se, you sort of still have that sort of bond with other people over a sort of a common interest. Unfortunately, there's a couple that sort of aren't around anymore, which is upsetting and it sucks. But yeah, I still keep in contact with some people. It was sort of a light bulb moment for me when I saw that my friends were sort of moving on with their life. They were sort of doing things. They were sort of getting different jobs and having different relationships. And that was sort of just me stuck being sick. And I think you get to a point after being sick for quite a while that you're sort of sick of being sick. And you don't want to be a drain on your social network, your family, and just this guy that's going constantly just like, oh, this is wrong. So I think that was the light bulb moment for me. I was like, nah, that's like, I've still got heaps of years to do stuff. I can achieve heaps of different things. Let's get on with it and let's get better.
Rough question, but did you ever feel like a burden?
Oh yeah, I still feel like a burden. Yeah, like that's something I always struggle with. And I'll openly admit that. But I think I just have to keep reminding myself of how far I've come and sort of what's ahead of me.
Did people ever ask you, why can't you just eat it?
I heard it from like one of my closest friends. He said that he just didn't understand why I can't eat it. Put it in your mouth and chew and swallow it. You're done. Which I think was ignorant and stupid. But I don't think badly of him for it. I think that was just sort of, at that time, everyone was really ignorant about what it is actually like to go through that and actually trying to eat a meal when you feel physically sick. You sort of wind yourself up so much about eating that meal that you actually don't feel hungry. And the thought of it just makes you feel physically sick. So yeah, I've had that comment a couple of times. I think as the time went on, I learnt sort of more and more guys are sort of suffering from it. The rise of sort of gyms and sort of everyone wanting you to look this certain way. I guess I didn't feel as alone. I felt a bit annoyed that sort of guys were just like, nah, it's all right, just toughen up, you'll be right. Shake it off, but I couldn't shake it off. And I saw other guys that sort of struggled with their body image issues, not being able to shake it off as well. And there just wasn't that sort of support from other guys that they needed. I get told to toughen up and sort of shake it off a fair bit. I got asked if I was addicted to drugs because I'd lost so much weight. So I think there's that sort of ignorance around sort of mental health as a whole with people, but sort of there's the ignorance of sort of body image issues with males a lot. Get help. There's nothing wrong with it. You're not weak. You can, like, you need to be able to speak and sort of be heard if you have issues.
How long have you been in recovery?
feels like a long time, maybe 5 years. This whole thing's gone on longer than it should have. But there's still a lot of work to do. I'll be the first to admit that. I'm always trying to sort of increase my mental health, work on body image issues. I'm so lucky I've got a great supportive network in my parents, my friends, my partner's been fantastic. It's up and down. You'll have good days, you'll have bad days, you'll have good weeks, you'll have terrible months. But if you've got that supportive network in your family, your friends, your partners, it makes it a whole lot easier if you're open about it.
What did recovery look like in terms of day-to-day, what you needed to?
It was different day-to-day, it depended on sort of your state of mind at the time. A bad day, I would not be able to do much. On a good day, I felt like I could climb the tallest mountain in the world. I could shake this off in another day. But I think just keeping yourself accountable and sort of meeting those small goals that you have is important.
What's it like when people compliment you now?
I still struggle a little bit just because, like, if it's comments around my body, I sort of have to remind myself that they're not trying to be jerks. They're actually probably just complimenting me.
So what are your relationships like now with your family, with your friends?
Completely different. There's no sort of toxic relationships with anyone now. Because I'm so open and honest about it now, I think it's made it a whole lot better. I'll admit when I'm struggling. So all my relationships are really good with my mum, my brother. Even when my dad passed away, we were great.
And what about your love life? I know that was something that...
I sort of met my partner 6 months ago. She actually knew about my eating disorder before. We went on our first date. She's been unbelievable. Sort of opened up parts of the world that I never thought would be open again around food. And the support she gives me is unbelievable and I can't thank her enough.
How did she know before your first date?
Stalking on Facebook.
Is it on your Facebook?
I shared a sort of an interview I'd done with another sort of media. And it sort of went around Facebook.
So you're very open about it now in your life?
Yeah, I'm happy to talk about it. If people need help, I'm always happy to help people. I've been pulled up at multiple parties with people saying, hey, I'm struggling with this sort of body image issue. Have you got any suggestions? And I'll happily sort of give them advice that I've learnt on my way through this. I think because I'm quite open about it, guys are sort of happy to sort of come to me and sort of be a bit open, a bit more vulnerable, which I love, because everyone suffers with different things. And I think talking and starting that conversation with each other is the most important thing. Because if you stay in your own head, it never gets better. I think it's just like that. I think guys were struggling to open up because it was that old school behavior of just like, get on with it. Stop being a sook, like stuff like that. I think it's changing now because you look at the statistics of guys committing suicide, it's through the roof. And I think now there's so many great people that are actually sort of taking the initiative to sort of go, hey, let's have a conversation about this. So I think it's definitely changing for the better. There's some great podcasts and sort of resources out there for guys that are struggling. I'm all about it.
Did it mess with your memory?
Yeah, I just can't remember a couple of years. There's like parts of my life I don't remember because my brain was so starved. I remember there's like parts of England I can't remember. I was really sick.
Do people ever unload on you and you're kind of like, not today? I don't want to talk about this today.
No, because I never sort of will admit that I'm struggling. I keep this sort of smiley face and everyone thinks everything's chipper, but deep down I'm really struggling. And I've always struggled with that. I've always struggled with sort of having this masking my real emotions. So I'll just constantly take on everything. And that's something I'm working on saying, hey, nah, not today. But I've always felt like I need to sort of help everyone and save everyone, even at the detriment to myself.
Is there anything that you think will stay with you forever in terms of the recovery?
I think the whole experience just stays with you. I can't, there's parts of my life I don't remember. There's parts of the years I don't remember because of this. But I think I'll always remember that sort of time when I thought, yeah, let's give it a red hot crack. Let's get better.